jury in the Susan Smith trial. Closing arguments in the trial's penalty phase are set for today, and jury deliberation could begin as soon as this afternoon. The panel must decide whether to give Smith the death sentence or life in prison for taking the lives of her two young sons. The Environmental Protection Agency could be the next victim of the National Budget Acts. The House today considers a spending bill that would cut the EPA's budget by one-third. And a warning for smokers with children. A new report says children of smokers are more than three times as likely to get respiratory infections as children of non-smokers. And finally, an unlikely duo is teaming up for good cause. Italian opera singer Luciano Pavarotti and Irish rock star Bono will perform together in Italy this September to help children in Bosnia. That's a quick look at what's making news now. Here's Jillian with the weather.
Today's weather is being brought to you by Comfort Inns and Suites. In the Northwest today, partly cloudy and warm, possible afternoon thundershowers. It'll be cooler in the coastal areas. And in the Northeast, it's cloudy, a little bit less humidity than the days before. Possible afternoon thundershowers also exist in the Northeast. Let's take a look at some of those high temperatures. Well, in some of our favorite cities across the country, like St. Louis, 94 degrees. Boston will be saying hello to those high 80s and 87 for the high today. And San Diego is a cool, balmy 76. That's the weather.
Thank you very much. For those of you who say that you don't have time in your lives for romance, listen up. There's a man with us today, Greg Goddard, author of 1001 Ways to Be Romantic. He says you've got to put romance into your daily lives.
Absolutely.
And he's here today to show us how, just in time, I might add, for Romance Month.
Awareness Month.
Romance Awareness
August
Month.
Is Romance Awareness
you know,
Month.
You know, I want to bet February was. How come August?
February is Creative Romance Month.
Oh.
Someone out in California created this. But see, now, look, August is 6 months after Valentine's Day, right?
Right.
Now is the time we need to be reminded that romance and relationships are really important, and it's not just about Valentine's Day.
Correct. It's not the one day of the month.
Can I suggest you gesture more?
I'm Italian, what can I say?
All right, so define romance, because I think it's different
okay,
for different
sure.
people.
Romance is really expressing your love. It's the action step of love.
Yeah.
You see, most guys think that romance is about flowers and candy and movies and jewelry and trips to Paris, and it's not. One of the key
yeah, right.
Silly them.
About, you know. But see, you scare guys away when you say stuff like that. You see? It's really about the little day-to-day things that you can do to keep your relationship alive.
Right.
Calling in the middle of the day, it's the littlest things that keep relationships going.
Yeah, actually, Greg has a very cute thing on his watch.
Oh,
he's
yes.
got a little heart on his watch.
Now,
if you're coming close,
that's right.
That reminds him to call his
Now, I don't
wife.
Need the reminder because I write these crazy books on romance.
Right.
I got this idea from a business guy in a meeting, and he said his wife used to always get mad at him because he never called.
Right.
He saw his kids playing with stickers. In fact, I have some for you here, too.
Oh, good.
See?
I'll take one. Yeah.
That's right. We have some for Tom here.
Okay, we should head over to
and
the
so Now, it's about little things, notes and so on, for instance.
Go in the fridge.
In the refrigerator.
A little love
Okay,
note.
Just a little note.
Drop those groceries and come join me for a treat.
Mmm. Mm.
Little things like that. I mean, that would make me smile if I saw that
That's
in my
right.
refrigerator.
See, there are things you can do
Bad
all
chance.
Throughout the house.
Yeah.
Your house should be your romantic hideaway, especially the bedroom. Okay?
Oh, rose now, petals on the bed. What
that's
do you
right.
want?
Just a little thing.
Larry?
When those roses are...
yes,
Where
Bob?
Is this guy?
This is for you, baby.
Hey,
oh,
look
honey,
at this.
Oh,
oh, oh. Ooh.
Anytime
so
you
romantic.
Get flowers, you get the kids, absolutely. So,
Listen, you should always have a bag packed and ready to go away, like for a surprise three-day weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Now, another thing you could do is create a romantic idea jar.
Okay.
Now, this, you just take little slips of paper.
It says, get a photo of your love and blow it up poster size.
The other one says, replace cool? screen door.
Don't mix it up with the job jar, that's for sure.
Oh, oh.
Otherwise, you're in big trouble.
Now, you can even be romantic in the bathroom.
Yeah?
Okay?
Who's that person
See,
in front
every
of
room in the house has that potential of being romantic, like running a bubble bath.
Oh, very
okay?
nice.
Now, have
rose
a bubble.
Petals.
Now, do it up, okay? Put rose petals in there. And, you know, that this old idea of taking a note and floating
it,
in
a bottle.
Now, see, remember I said the little things,
yeah.
little touches? Now, this is not for summer, okay?
Okay.
But for guys, if you want to really do it up in the winter, you take the towel, you
it
warm it up in the tub, and when she gets out of that tub, ooh,
that's a nice touch.
Those
that's
things
sure.
are just tremendous.
Yeah. What if romance isn't your style, though? What if you feel uncomfortable?
Okay. Romance is about you being romantic in your own style.
You have
it's
to
not about roses and classic things. Like, I know a guy who was in one of my romance classes. He's a truck driver, okay? Not a typically romantic guy.
Right.
on Christmas, there was no snow locally up in Boston where he lived. He drove his dump truck up to Maine, filled it up with snow, brought it back, and put snow in the front yard for his wife.
What a snow job.
Now, see, that's what romance is all about. Yeah, you don't have to write it. You don't have to say it. You can do it in your own style.
Greg Goddick, Mr. Romantic, telling us some ways to keep the romance alive. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You got me a kiss.
Thanks, Greg. Yeah, I know what I'm doing wrong with Lois. I'm just not gesturing enough. So we'll be right back after this.
Meet a book-loving, kind, angry acoustic guitarist, Elliot Smith, real talented, though not yet a household name, on Breakfast Time.
At FX, we recognize the importance of family values like honesty.
I am not a murderer. That was an accident.
Generosity.
How dare you buy Stephen's son for Crystal?
Integrity.
That reptile which you call a son has accused Monica and me of incest.
Empathy.
Now listen to me, you little tramp.
I really wish I had time to jerk you around, Alexis.
And FX recognizes that ever-important family value of cleanliness.
I know you, Adam, because it stinks of you.
Get your FX fix of family values with Dynasty. Weekdays at 9 Eastern, noon Pacific, only on FX.
This is it, folks. Bottom of the ninth. Esty looks in for a sign. Swung on! A towering drive to center field!
What?
California grapes. The natural snack.
Hi, I'm Julie.
Julie, can I ask you something?
With Tom and Lori and Bob the Puppet? Oh, okay, sorry. Welcome back to Breakfast Time with Tom and Lori and Bob the Puppet. I'm Jillian, sitting in for Jim the announcer, and I just messed up.
Now, Jillian.
That's okay.
Take it.
Go.
Jessica's here. Jessica just walked in.
Oh, did she, Jessica? Yep. Join us. Hello, guys.
Yay.
Good morning. How are you?
Good.
You can take that microphone.
It's a little, I know. You stroll in, you're immediately thrust on the air.
Whoever designed this should come to California and just meet me at my apartment.
Chris Shriver.
I'm really excellent job.
Let me introduce you to some of the people. First of all, that's Lori Hibbert.
Hi, I'm interviewing you. Nice to meet you.
I'm Tom Bergeron. And there's Bob Zipapet.
Hi, Bob.
These are our visiting viewers from Albion, Michigan, Kathy and Ray Campbell.
Hi, oh, it's nice to meet you.
That's Cyber Babe.
Hi, you did great. I saw you.
Did you see that segment?
Yeah, I thought that was excellent.
This is all sort of our producers, and Spencer's one of our road warriors.
Yeah, those are producers. That's Paul Schaefer.
All kinds of people who are really beyond the tip of the iceberg who make the show possible every day. And this is Elliot Smith. Elliot is going to talk to us and perform for us from his latest CD.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd love to hear
I think
it.
You're pretty much caught up now.
Yeah. Great. Well, now, that's basically what's going on at Breakfast Time. Yeah. But we have a whole day's worth of programming here on FX.
Is we leave the house or you're here all the time?
No, we stay here all day. It's called the FX Day and Jillian has it all lined up for you.
Yes, on Fantasy Island, Mr. Wark plays Cupid when he matches up a couple seeking a lifetime of happiness together. But there's a dangerous price to be paid for their everlasting love. And on Nanny and the Professor, visiting Uncle Horace performs a traditional South Seas rain dance. Will his efforts save the drought-ridden countryside, or is it all a hoax? The Pet Department, with Steve Walker and Suzanne Wong. Getting rid of pet stains and odors. Suzanne Wong has some helpful tips for pet owners. Check it out. It's the best of breakfast time. Tom and Lori, Saturday and Sunday mornings here on FX.
Yo, check it out.
Okay.
That was. Could you get a more sullen freeze for that?
Yeah, give you a flattering shot.
I want to watch the show with the guy with the intestinal disorder on. I can't wait to watch that one. Let's welcome a real morning person to the show.
Yep.
it's going to be all right, Elliot. Elliot.
Don't lie to him.
Elliot Smith is here with us. His CD is entitled, not surprisingly, Elliot Smith. And it is on. Now, this is an intriguing label. Is this, getting this right? Kill Rock Stars?
That's right. Yeah. It's a punk label.
Feeling a little hostile, are we, Elliot?
It's not my label.
Oh, it's not your label? Oh, okay.
But I wish it was.
Yeah, so back off.
You wish it was? Now, you say that your music's not loud, but it tends to be kind of angry.
Yeah, some of it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Are you? Would you classify? Because I mean, this is sort of a circus-like environment to drag you into at this hour of the morning, and I'm wondering if there's a potential that any of us might come to physical harm.
I don't think you'll have that kind of problem.
Okay. All right. Bob, you're safe.
Okay.
All right. How would you describe the type of music that you record when you're not recording with the group, when you're doing your solo stuff?
It's really quiet. Mm-hmm. It's some of it's really angry, some of it's not. It's not really folk, but it's sort of like that.
Yeah. So like if you're in an argument with a friend, are you the one that will just quiet down and storm out of the room, or you just kind of stare
at a song about him?
You go write a song about him.
No, I don't do that. But yeah. No, I mean it's not like particularly angry.
Because I notice on the cover, but people are jumping off buildings, and I'm wondering if that's
a statue.
That's not necessarily a good approach to deal with your problems. I mean, what's the symbolism of that?
I don't know. It just looked good.
Yeah, the stunt people didn't think so. What are you going to sing for us from the CD?
It's called Clementine.
Clementine, all right. Elliot Smith.
Cool.
And Cyber Babe, by the way. Have you met Cyber Babe?
Yeah.
All right.
Waking you up to close the bar. The street's what you can tell by the sound of the car. Bartender singing Clementine while he's turning around the open sign. Dreadful sorry Clementine. Though you're still her man, time gone. Maybe the whole thing's wrong. What if she thinks so, but just didn't say so? You drank yourself in too slow-mo. Made an angel in the snow. Pass the time and keep that song out of your mind. Oh my darling, oh my darling, oh my darling, Clementine. Dreadful sorry, Clementine. Dreadful sorry, Clementine.
Very nice.
Remember when a gentleman would do anything for a damsel in distress?
These shoes are killing me.
Heart to heart, because high heels can be murder. Weekdays, exclusively on FX.
So sweet.
It's 24 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Breakfast Time with Lori, Tom, and Bob the Puppet. Sitting in for Jim the Announcer is me, Jillian. And now here's Tom, Lori, and a very special guest.
Yes, that's right, Jessica Heck.
Joining us from...
We're from about seven or eight sitcoms.
Yeah,
I forget how many.
Got them all lined up this
You got fall. Friends, yeah. You got The Single Guy,
and
what
my
else?
Life.
Brady
that's
Bunch.
It.
Yeah.
My life and the Friends and The Single Guy.
All right.
And a little mailbag music.
How about another hand, first of all?
I'm going...
Yeah.
Wait. No. My apologies.
Listen and learn. How about another hand for Elliot Smith? fine number.
Hey.
Thanks, Elliot. Who is craving, you're craving a cigarette big time right now, aren't you?
Yeah. Okay.
And we're making him stay.
That's right.
Now, please, a little mailbag music.
I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter.
Now, this one's very nice. This is very, we've all been invited to a wedding.
Oh, that's nice.
Enclosed, you will find a wedding invitation address of the Breakfast Time gang. This from Diane. It looks like Brown from Trenton, Michigan. And she writes that Bob could be the flower puppet. This is after I could be the best man, you could be maid of honor. Aunt Mary could bake the cake. Cassandra, these are some of our family members here. Cassandra could arrange the flowers. Jim could make sure that only spiky yellow ball showed up on August 13th, the day of the nuptials. Paul, noted producer, Paul Shavelson over there in the kitchen, could arrange and direct the ceremony and picture taking. And he could be in charge of footwear if we can get a shot. Behind, be in charge of ceremonial wedding footwear.
Hey, Paul, why don't you just paint a target on yourself? What is that, the Billy Bigelow look? Hand back the whole outfit.
That's from Diane Brown and Jim Michaels from Trenton, Michigan. Much success with the nuptials. I don't know if we can make it. We'll be there in spirit.
Certainly. And we'll maybe say hi to you on that day if we can keep the invitation around. This from Dave Hofstede of Las Vegas, Nevada. Dear Tom Laurie, this page from the new edition of the Celebrity Directory. If it is any indication, the two of you had better contact your agents. Now, this is a celebrity directory. Celebrities' names and their addresses. Got Michael Bolton on here, Irma Bong,
Wade
Danny
Boggs.
Bonaducci.
That's a celebrity?
Yeah.
Okay.
And
come in tight here, Jim.
Oh, you got to see this. The only FX celebrity on here.
Jack the dog.
No.
Bob! Bob!
Eat your hearts out, humans.
He's our puppet. Yes, he is. Thank you.
You get a T-shirt suitable for marrying in, actually.
Yeah.
And Jillian, tell people how they get their letters or faxes or emails ready.
Well, they can write to us at Breakfast Time, P.O. Box 825, Madison Square Station, New York, New York, 10159-0825. Or they can give us a phone call. And it's, email first, okay, fxbreakfasttimedelphi.com. They can call us at telephone number 800-FX-FX-FX-1. Fax us at 212-802-4208.
Thank you very much. Let's head to Newport, Rhode Island right now. John Davis is at the Surface Warfare Officer School Command on the Newport Naval Base. And what do we see in this hour, J.D.?
We're going to, this is the Engine Command Center. And these are the machines that control everything that runs the engines aboard these ships. And we're going to see a simulation of what happens when something goes wrong. Lieutenant Schmidt is here. Now, Lieutenant, you're one of the instructors here. You're actually in charge of this whole setup.
Yes, I'm the curriculum coordinator in charge of the trainers here.
Okay, briefly, what are we looking at here? What's that?
Sure. Well, all this room is a replica of the Bruins-class destroyer. It's the central control station where we start the engines over here at that console. And to my right here is the electric plant control console where you can start and stop the electrical generators and change the status of the electric plant.
And this is the only place where the people who come here to train encounter situations where they're not actually, you know, because when it happens aboard a ship, you're in trouble.
That's right. We try casualty control here. We practice evolutions where equipment breaks, and this is the only time where we can have things go wrong and everybody laugh about it.
Okay, we have Lieutenant Stacy here who's an instructor. He's the only one who has fun because you design the scenarios.
Yes, sir. What I do is I put in the problems here and they've got to solve them.
All right, let's see it. Let's see a simulation of what's going
wrong.
It's
like me. All right. Right now?
All right. Here we go. This is a simulation, and this is what would happen in the engine control room if there was a problem aboard the ship.
Right now, there was a loss of fuel oil pressure, and it's an exact simulation. Petty Officer Curry is securing the fuel system right now, as would take place right on the ship. As you notice, Lieutenant Hart, the EOW, he's in charge of communications. And he's telling the engine room and telling the bridge.
Dr. Howard, Dr. Fine, Dr. Howard.
Okay, so at this point, everyone aboard the ship would be scrambling to try to figure out what the problem is.
The people in the engineering department predominantly. Now there's a major fuel oil leak. They've located the problem, so they're going to have to secure the engines, which is what Petty Officer Curry is doing now.
And how much time do they have to solve the problem?
In about 50 seconds, we should have this problem secured.
Okay, right now what was with the electrical system here?
Well, there's a leak in the engine room. We had to secure the generator.
Lost number one generator.
The problem is... One generator had to take the entire load. Sometime it overtemps. Right now, we have a loss of electrical power on the ship.
Great. We're doing radio again.
I know.
Just keep playing the hits.
Petty Officer Curry is right now trying to monitor his plant. And Petty Officer Senior Chief Petty Officer Wilburn is starting another generator to get the lights back.
It's like we're in the Batcave all of a sudden.
So the whole time, they're constantly...
That's right.
They're constantly communicating with the different departments and the different... That's points right. in the ship.
This is the brains. This is where it all takes place, and the communication is vital. Duh. It just broke out into a fire. That's why they sounded general quarters.
Okay, great. Now we have a fire on board the ship. All right, let's go back to Lieutenant Stacy over here.
I need more power now.
This is the USS Lucky.
How did they do?
They did outstanding. They did outstanding. These guys, kind of like a stacked deck here. These guys know exactly what's going to go on because they've got all the initial actions memorized for all 45 or so drills that we do. So anything I throw at them is pretty hard to beat because they're very talented individuals out here.
And as you look around, the gentlemen in this room are instructors who are training to be instructors, and all of them will be able to run this command center in this simulator. And it's to teach the guys and the women what to do in case of an emergency in the engine room.
Terrific. Thank you very much, John Davis. John is in Newport, Rhode Island this morning.
I have just a behind-the-scenes request. Can we take a shot of Jillian in the booth?
Yeah.
No, I don't have a camera.
You don't have a camera?
No.
All right. Jillian, can you squeak for us some more?
Oh, did you hear my squeaking?
Yes, we did.
I know. I'm in this small booth, and so sometimes I just need to turn around. Can you hear it?
Oh, no. No.
Well, is that you or the chair?
No, it hasn't.
Oh.
Hey, we got the same lighting they do on the remote.
Handyman Joe down there.
Oh, yeah. Get him down
Where's
here to
Handyman
help
Joe?
Me out.
Handyman Joe. Come on. All the way down to the booth, we have a squeaky chair messing with the show.
Good, we found a way to get him out of the apartment after his segments are over.
Right now, let's take a look at other things squeaking and cracking across the planet.
Hello, everyone. I'm Vernon Shaw. Here's what's making headlines. As Chicago residents brace for temperatures in the 90s this weekend, the already staggering death toll from last heat wave continues to rise. Officials say dozens more bodies from funeral homes and hospitals have been counted, bringing the number of heat-related deaths to 529. Mm. It's calm again in Miami's Coconut Grove area. Officials say violence broke out overnight, apparently in reaction to a recent police shooting of a teenager. Meanwhile, in Indianapolis, police arrested 12 people and used tear gas to break up a second night of riots. Officials say residents were protesting claims of police brutality. Two new moons have been discovered around Saturn, and astronomers say there could be two more. The moons were spotted in photographs taken by the Hubble Space Telescope. The ring planet already has 18 known natural satellites. And finally, birthday wishes going out to Garfield creator Jim Davis, who turns 50 years old today, and actress Sally Struthers, who turns 47. Well, that's a quick look at what's making news now. Here's Jillian with the weather.
Well,